Hello, this is a video to show how to add displacement map into Blender material. This is default scene in Blender. I delete the default object and I add another object. Go to add mesh, I add a plane, and then go to the add plane panel. I rotate it in x-axis to 90 degrees to make it vertical. And then we can add material into this plane. I will split the viewport into two. One is for preview the material, another one I will switch to shader editor. We can add the new material in the shader editor, click new, and then principal BSDF load is added. I close this panel first, and then we can close up to view the shader load, and then we can use the image texture. I use shortcut shift A to search image texture, shift A to search mapping, shift A to search texture coordinate, and then I will use generate collapse to vector of the mapping, vector of the mapping collapse to vector of the image texture, color of the image texture collapse to base color of principal BSDF load, and then we can go to open in the image texture loops and link the image. I have prepared the image texture. This is the image texture generated by generative AI. We can find the video in this video description. Now I use this image texture and open the image. And then in the 3D viewport, we can press EZ to change to material preview. This is how we can add image texture into material. If you want to add displacement map into material, firstly, make sure that we have enough mesh. I snatch the object and go to add the mode and right click on the object and choose subdivide. We can add number of cuts. I will use 50. So number of polygons is added, and then we can go back to object mode and go to render properties. We can switch the render engine to cycle, and in the feature sets, we can switch to experimental. Now I open the side panel of shader editor and go to options, settings. In the displacement, we can switch to displacement and bump. I close this panel, and then we can add another image texture loop, shift A to search image texture, shift A to search displacement, and then I will use color of image texture collapse to height of displacement, displacement collapse to displacement of the material output, and then go back to image texture loops and link the image. I will choose the displacement mapping and open the image. Now we can go back to 3D viewport and press shortcut EZ to see the render preview. It doesn't have the lighting, so we can go to the world, and I will use sky texture, shift A to search sky texture, and use the color, collapse to color of background. I will use 0.1 in strength, and I will adjust the size of the sun to 50, and in the sun elevation, I will use 33. The sun rotation, I will use 230. Now we can go back to the object and we can reduce the strength of the displacement. I will use 0 in the mid level, and scale, I will use 0.1. Or we can use 0.2. to adjust the depth of the displacement map. So if I disconnect the base color, we can see the displacement map only. I collect it again. If we disconnect the displacement, we can see the before and we can see the after. Some of the cases, we can add subdivision surface modifier to make it nicer. Go to modifier properties and add a modifier, generate, we can choose subdivision surface modifier. This is how we can add displacement map into blended material. Thank you for watching this video. Hope this helped. Please subscribe to this channel. More video will be shared with you. I'm Matisby. See you in the next video. Bye bye.